Okay.
The world has ended. Where are we now?
5-1. I'm missing two, and I don't know what the second one is.
Oh, yeah, I seem to remember you missing that one, and I was like, wait, what? How did you, what?
But the first one, I need fire, which there's gotta be some fire in here. Please, Tom, for the love of crap, there's gotta be some fire
don't
in here.
Don't think there's fire in... Oh, wouldn't you know? There's mini fire.
I still haven't... I never found that comet! Hey, let's find that fucking comet. Kirby 64. Ooh, get a load of that rich lag.
Tasty.
Do you remember what episode you lived? Oh, it was probably on Matter of Miracles.
Probably, yeah.
Just pause. Oh, and that, it's actually muted. How convenient. One.
That's nice. Muted. All right, let's see. I think I commented on like every video, though, so.
Well, yeah, but yeah, I'm not going to confuse one comment for another. Spiny Snowflake. Oh, bomb. And I showed Snowman.
Okay, so it's, isn't that Spike and Snow
Spike and
Double Stone?
Yeah, Spike and Snow and Double Stone. Okay, cool. That's what it is.
Cool.
Which, anyway,
Spike and Snow was like sick. It's an awesome power.
It's pretty weak. It's cool.
Well, yeah, but it's cool. Whereas Mr. Phoenix here, this is what I always used for that advancing lave of lava.
Oh yeah, because it's really easy to find it there.
Yep, and then you just go. Oh, this chill music.
Ow.
Luckily, there's some meat. Man, whenever I see meat, I always think it's gonna heal too, but it's just one.
Because in Squeak Squad,
yep,
it heals like three times as much as
How did you miss that penguin?
I don't know. Cherries. That's the lowest one, aside from the assorted
like food.
Flans and pancakes and shit.
The worst thing to get out of a box ever. Those ones.
Dog. Did I ever show what you can get by holding those guys above your head?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you showed pretty much everything holding.
Ew, I hate that fucking guy!
So much you can do.
Well, you could wait.
Well, okay, yeah.
I didn't go past
Mr.
it, did I?
Mr. Impatience here.
Oh, well,
this is the first one that's easy, right?
We'll play the level again. Oh, yeah, yeah, I'll know when I get the first one. I love this toboggan. It reminds me of the log flumes from Roller... It's like the kind of car you'd see in Roller Coaster Tycoon on, like, one of the novelty cars on, like, Roller Coaster
or
whatever.
Oh, man, what a good game.
Bobsled run, that's what
I'm You should do a Roller... Have you done Roller Coaster?
I did Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. I did Electric Fields. It was two videos.
Right.
But I never did any more than that.
Okay. I always used to play Zoo Tycoon.
Have you heard the remix of this from Canvas Curse?
I don't think so. Man, I should check that out.
Oh yeah, Canvas Curse's entire soundtrack is like remixes.
Sheesh.
The last level of the game remixes Nightmare Wizard for its stage music. It's really awesome. Oh, this is confusing too. This isn't color coded either. You gotta use fire.
I think you meant. Wait. I save.
Why didn't that hurt him?
Yeah, cause. Man, Phoenix is really not. Wow, is he invincible when he's doing his little ice shield?
Who?
The snowman.
You called him Phoenix.
No, I started a sentence and then I didn't finish it and then
no!
I...
No! Oh, I can go back. What?
Hello?
Ladies and gentlemen. Okay, let's try that again.
Oh man.
Good lord. At least we get to use at least we get to do the dude, bring Bandicam back up, you fucking idiot.
Dude.
At least we get to do the, dude, you are...
You
gotta work on your pitch, man. Da, 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 da. We get to do the factory.
Ooh, the factory. Oh, man. Probably one of my favorite songs.
Oh, yeah.
This whole game. Aside from... Oh, man.
What? Why did... Why'd you go like 2.5 negative feet?
Dude. You literally went backwards. Whatever, we got a 1-up in this level, so.
Yeah, do you understand? I literally could not give less of a shit about dying.
Yeah, I know.
I'm not gonna get a game over in Kirby 64.
You were at like 1 life and low health in one of your episodes, I think.
Okay.
So it was close, man.
Yeah, to dying. Oh, right. I was down to zero at one point. I got close.
Yeah.
I got close. I did get close. Should I do the boss endurance?
I don't know. Does it add anyone extra? It doesn't, does it?
No, it doesn't. Mm,
which is too bad.
They didn't do that until Superstar Ultra.
Okay. I was always liked that.
Mark Sultan, Superstar Ultra was the pioneer for a lot of shit that would go on to make Kirby really fucking awesome.
Yeah.
Like Galactinite, who is so awesome they put him in every single fucking game.
Yep.
Except Triple Deluxe, where they put Dark Metanite instead.
Okay. I mean, still pretty awesome.
Yeah.
I had to go and listen to Galactinite's theme when you told Kyle about it.
Yeah. Oh man, I wanted to make an 8-bit. I wanted to do try and make an 8-bit remix of Galactinite's theme, but the part at the end where it goes. Does not fit in any time signatures.
No.
And I'm pretty sure FamiTracker does not support, like, the, you know, NES, like, right. Style music composing software. I'm pretty sure it doesn't support wonky time signatures. But everything else is in totally normal 4/4. It's like, son of a bitch. I think I've listened to Galactinite's theme too much, because I could probably sing the whole thing right now.
Yeah, that's the, you know, your first indicator there.
And when you're, and like, you know, maybe if you were talking about Crown, you could be like, oh yeah, people memorize Crown, that's an awesome theme. But nobody fucking memorizes Galactinite's theme. Like, it's awesome, but it's just not the kind of music that you would memorize.
Yeah, no.
It's like memorizing the Ripple Star Catacombs music. I can't even get a handle on that. The intervals between, like, when they do the, you know, when the da-da-da-da-da, when that goes up to da-da-da-da-da-da, yep. It's totally fucking random.
You are now...
Dude, excuse me.
You...
Excuse me. I would like to report you to my superior... I don't know what the hell I'm talking about.
What are you... What... Didn't you need the fire?
No, I already broke it.
Oh yeah. We just went through, right.
When you said that, I panicked for a second, like, did I break it?
Oh, no. Just like, what?
Okay, now what do we... Oh, it's beneath the ice. You know, because it's in the water.
Does that mean we need fire?
Are you kidding? No, those cracks. Wow.
Let's do it really quietly.
Fucking incredible how off-key you are.
What?
You didn't know that? You can jump.
You can just jump right.
You can jump
right.
Up, and they like.
It's like
they
it paused like, for like, a second.
What do you reckon Nerf tastes like?
What a question. I have no idea.
Probably just like pork. I mean, it's like a boar.
Pretty much, yeah. It's like
some really gamey pork because it's all muscly and mighty.
Yep, that'd be wild. Actually, wild boar, if it's like cooked over 3 days on an open fire on a spit, can be like really good. Not that I necessarily have experience with that, but
I would have figured that just from Asterisk and Obelisk.
That's true, but
what the fuck?
Bison. I've had bison spit roasted over a fire.
I've had pemmican.
Like a whole bison. It was really good.
Ow. Excuse you, dickweed.
There's a hole.
Yeah, I see it.
What are these little cloud guys called?
I don't fucking know. These games... I don't fucking know. This isn't Kirby and the Amazing Mirror. They don't all have health bars with names above them.
Wait, we need to get... Oh, wow. Yeah. Alright, what do we got left?
By the way, how fucking awesome is it that I fucking remembered this guy's name?
Pretty awesome. I would never
oh,
have.
No.
Oh.
Oh, no. Oh. Can I get Spike... Can I get Needle Lightning in this level?
I almost think you can.
I'm just gonna go get it somewhere
but
else.
But yeah.
Because it's right at the end where you need it.
Yeah. So best not to test
best
our
knowledge.
Best not
to go there.
Let's just skip that one. Let's just pretend you got it. You can, like, edit in 100%.
I'll just edit in 100%, and then I'll edit in a 0-2 fight while
yeah,
I'm
that
at
too.
It.
Go find, like, a really, like, MLG 0-2 fight.
I don't think it's possible to do an MLG 0-2 fight. That fight is practically scripted.
Yeah, that's true.
0-1, on the other hand. Have you... No, you haven't.
Nope.
That is a hard fight. Like, holy crap. Those early Dreamland 2 and 3 do not mess around. I probably died to Dark Matter in Dreamland 2 for like half an hour.
Sheesh.
And it looks so simple. You would never guess that it's such a fucking pain in the ass.
I think I watched like a top 10 hardest bosses or something. Or like bosses that surprised us. I think it was like bosses that surprised us and what that was in there.
Yeah, and lots of I am not fucking surprised. That boss fight is way harder than you'd think it would be.
Oh, you get a show off Snowflake.
Yeah.
Yay.
Because I'm here, you know, what the fuck. That's a really nice color combo. It's got that Splatoon colors.
It's so purdy.
It's so useless. Anyway. Yeah,
I love how Spike like impales enemies so violently in this game.
Yeah, and they just like immediately freeze or like, this is how like, I die. I'm dead.
And they just explode. That was a weird explosion.
Oh, did I ever tell you did I ever mention in the LP, oops. Did I ever mention in the LP that I looked up the name of that spider enemy?
Nope, I don't think so. I
think it's Mariel.
Mariel.
Yeah. So it's like, is it a lady or something? I guess.
It's a lady spider.
It's weird, like, getting canonical, this is a lady
kind
of confirmations in Kirby. Like, Kabula. Like, what? Kabula is a lady.
Okay, then.
I'll take it. Sure. What do you... I'll take it. You do not want to know how long it took for me to realize this was a remix of Butter Building.
I'm just listening to it. I mean, it is a pretty remixed remix. Yeah.
Still not as good, I don't think. Oh, it's right up there with the music from Nutty Noon. You know that?
Yep.
Yeah. From that level with all like the ropes.
Yeah.
And you get wing and you get to fly through and cut all the ropes with your wings.
Yes, yes.
And just drop Waddledees into the abyss.
Just when you thought Mario was the bad guy.
How much have you seen of Kirby Star Allies?
Very little.
You know they're bringing back Clean?
Really?
Yeah. And it's it puts the animal buddies are in the animations.
Cool.
It's basically just all of the combinations with the Clean and the animal buddies from Kirby Dream Land 3 made into a moveset.
Nice.
They're that also awesome. They're bringing back Paint, but they revamped it. It's called Artist now, and it's based on Adeline. You can like paint. You can like paint a DDD that runs forward and hammers stuff.
Sick.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to convince my friend to get this.
They're also bringing back Yo-Yo.
Ah, and the Gim. Classic.
And Burning Leo's running animation isn't completely fucking stupid anymore.
That's good.
Where he's like going, like literally, his running animation is like he like swings his hair around.
Oh man,
I hurt my neck. Ow.
They should bring back. Remember, you accidentally missed this one, or no? Did you miss this one?
Oh, you know, I got it in the, I got it with Kyle.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, I missed it like a fucking idiot in the first.
Yeah, I remember. But they should bring back Mirror.
Mirror was in Robobot.
You're right, it was.
It was cool, but like, meh, it didn't really get enough new to make it really interesting. It was pretty much just the forward move,
okay,
like the regular move, the dash move. The shield, and there was a move where Kirby would, like, make a stack of mirror images above himself, and make, like, mirror images around him if you pressed down. That was it. I think it would be...
Triumphant return.
But... You know what I would do if I made mirror? Would... I mentioned this to Cthulhuigi in Discord. Yeah. If you, like... There's a power-up in Super Mario 3D World called the Copy Cherry.
Right.
That clones you, and you have, like, a second clone that you could, like, catch on a wall to separate and pick up two rows of coins at once or whatever. So what if you could make a mirror image of yourself that could die really easily but had equal offensive potential, could pick up items, and if you guarded, you could still move it around. So you could position, kind of like, well, you wouldn't know that, Jacob and Esau from Anti-Birth.
Actually, no, I think I've heard of that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I did start playing Anti-Birth a little bit before.
It's pretty good. Oh, yeah. I hate this fucking room with this ability because they always pop up from under your fucking feet.
Yup.
Oh, I'm fiery mad. I'm fiery Bowser. Oh, that didn't give me as much lift as I expected.
Wow, zap. Yeah. Murdered another innocent.
I think these guys, these like chompy dudes.
I just call them snappies.
Snappies?
Snappies.
I wish I could get like all. One of these days I have to like go through and just play this game over and over and over and over.
Just yes. Thank you. One of those moments when you're just not really sure what to do or say or think, so you just throw yourself off the edge. It hurt.
I can't believe it.
It hurt.
I can't believe I lost it.
How far were we into that level?
That was the last room. Okay, here's Double Stone.
Hello, Double Stone. Here we go.
What do fucking do? Mighty Kirby Golem! Hoo-ah! It's a powerful.
Oh, goodness. The almighty Kirby has arrived. Bow before him. Except then you walk into, like, a mini-boss and you just...
Honestly, pretty effective ability.
It's true!
I mean, you can kill an enemy. You can hurt mini-bosses with the explosion, so...
Yeah. Can you walk through a Gordo now that they're gone?
No, you can't.
Okay.
You can't.
So you're not fully invincible.
Gordos will still... I don't think... Oops. I don't think you could walk through... Could you walk through Gordos with metal?
Yeah, I think so. Metal was, like, the invincibility. Like, there was... pretty much nothing that could harm you,
except
right?
For mini bosses.
Except for mini bosses.
And bosses. Against which it was literally useless, as opposed to stone in this game's mostly useless.
Well, stone is great for that, for what's his face? The shark boss.
What?
In
Oh, Gobbler.
Yes,
I thought you were talking about Acro in this game.
No. Gobbler.
Yeah.
Or Smash, even. Or Crat. No, Smash. Oh my goodness, I can't even speak. Smash. You can absolutely annihilate him.
They brought back Smash in Robot also.
Sheesh. And that but you could only... was close.
The kill line was a lot further down than it looks.
Okay.
You could only get Smash by finding, like, secret rooms, though. The room in Kirby's Adventure where you can get UFO really early. But there was one in every world, so if you could find it, you could get Smash and kick some ass.
Yeah.
And it was based on a Smash 4 moveset, so...
Sick.
It had, like, the infinitely charging fiery hammer flip.
Infinitely charging. Oh, man. Little hammer flip.
That was pretty close to hitting that tarot. Whatever that thing's called. I don't care.
The purple flying thing.
Purple flying tarot. I think they're called like Terra.
Terra.
Like P-T-E-R-A.
Terra means earth in Latin.
Not with a P in front of it and one R.
Well, no.
Also, thank you for the lesson, Professor John. I'm pretty sure nobody ever knew that.
I took a Latin course.
I think if you went on Google and was like most known Latin words, Terra would be like number one.
Actually, there's a lot of words that are Latin that people don't know are Latin.
Words that people know are Latin. Words that haven't been adopted into the English language. We don't need Terra in English. We already have the word Earth for that.
Words like super is Latin.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I thought it was Greek.
Maybe hyper is Latin then. One of the two, because I took Greek and Latin.
Why the fuck was that knowledge in my head? Even if it's wrong, why did I?
That just occurred to me. I was like, wait a second, how? Wait, and you were so quick off the bat. Just like, nah, I think it's Greek actually. I'm like, oh yeah, okay, yeah.
Fuck you, stupid oxygen. Why do you smell like?
What?
You smell like, and I don't want to be, I mean this in like the most flattering way possible. You smell like an Asian fast food restaurant.
I was in St. Patel Mall yesterday.
That would do it. That would do it.
Yeah. I'm hungry now. I want food.
Yeah, we went grocery shopping yesterday, ooh. So we have the... Are you fucking kidding me?! Exactly the same way. The same fucking enemy.
My heart?
This is not happening.
How?
And I'm going the wrong way to get to Popstar.
Oh my goodness.
This isn't even the last level on the list.
How many more do we have?
We have to do Factory, and we have to do Catacombs.
That's a long level, too.
I think I'm just missing the first one.
Okay, good.
No, Drill and Lightsaber. Oh, well. That's pretty near the end. I don't think we need to do the... We might not need to do the area with the hammers and DDD. That always makes me really nervous.
Yeah.
I hate that area.
Yeah.
Scary. It's scary.
Oh, man.
But hey, we gotta listen to this music more.
Yeah?
Yeah, this music more. Oh, I've shown every ability now. That's nice.
People can't see me waving my head about, but I am.
Okay, hang on, let's just...
breathe.
I love how it slows down right before the loop. It's like the person playing it is falling asleep, and then they would like wake back up at the loop. It's like, wait, shit!
I mean, I can fall asleep to that music, so...
I'm pretty sure I probably have.
Yeah.
You know what music I actually could fall asleep to more than that, though?
What?
The Castle Dedede music. That
really?
That plays in the Quicksand Cave. Have you ever listened to that on loop?
Nope.
You know that's a remix of the Iceberg theme from Dreamland 3.
I didn't actually.
The bass line is the music. It's do 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 do.
Can that make sense? Yeah. I like falling asleep to like classical music.
And, like, but yeah,
nice piano.
Castle Dedede in this game is probably one of my favorite Kirby songs ever.
It's up there.
That's the one that you know the rest of the song, yeah. Like if Castle, I don't think Castle DDD has a theme, like.
Not really.
But that would be it.
Yeah. Is it in any other game?
It got remixed. The Iceberg theme got remixed in Return to Dreamland for like a couple rooms and in Egg Engines.
Ah, yeah.
It was a. It's like, I think it's when you're in like the sewers, and the music starts like.
Oh yeah.
And then it goes.
Yep. Yeah, I can remember that.
It's like so violent.
Oh man, Return to Dreamland, just epic music.
Oh yeah.
I mean, all
definitely.
Kirby games, pretty much, but.
Yeah, you haven't listened to the Robobot or Triple Lock soundtracks much, have you?
Nope. I did. I think I've listened the whole Robobot soundtrack through.
Dude,
once.
You gotta listen to Queen Sectonia's battle themes, man.
That, okay. Her, yes. Yeah, I've listened to those quite a bit.
Sullied Grace. I remember when it used to be called Dirty and Beauty. That doesn't make any fucking sense, but it was more. I think it was more poetic than Sullied Grace. Like, it was a cooler name, even if it didn't make as much sense.
Yeah. Sully Grace is pretty awesome. You know what you should do?
What?
Cave Story.
I should do Cave Story.
You really should do Cave Story.
Yeah, I have, like, I still have, like, the original it's not, like, with the weirdly, like, taller character sprites. I have the very original version still from, like, when I first downloaded it in, like, 2008.
Yeah. Oh, man. What a game.
Want to take bets on whether or not it's going to happen again.
Yes.
No, though.
No, though.
If it happens again, I might just stop the recording. I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
It's fucking hell! They arc so much lower than I expect them to.
These guys. Okay. We gotta do this. Remember, stop on that platform.
Stop on that platform. Check and turn and signal to the right. Then turn to the right.
At least we get to listen to this music lots. This is good music.
Yeah, this is good music.
It's like classic Kirby music.
I mean, it pretty much literally is.
Yeah.
It's like from the second game Kirby ever had. Okay, now just chill the fuck out. Was that so fucking hard?
Whew! Okay, I can breathe again. You almost slipped down that hole. Nah. That would have been bad.
No, I know what I'm doing. Except for that one jump.
Except for that. Well, I mean,
what the hell?
This whole level is just wow, cool.
Yeah.
Perfectly timed jump there. Okay.
Okay. See, look how fucking that's how fucking close we were. And and just as like a fucking joke, the boss is one of those sons of bitches.
It's like you just got wrecked by these guys. Now you gotta fight a big one. There we go.
Okay. Fucking finally.
Whew.
And guess what?
What?
That's the end of the level. It's exactly at the end.
Oh, bad.
Oh, man, I got a copy. Hey, we got to see that, though, in the LP.